I'm right now in another meme coin trade. Each and every day, meme coins right now are giving massive opportunities. Solana basically up 50% in just the last 3 weeks is giving a lot of these Solana meme coins some massive, massive gains. We're going to go over and begin on deck screener like I always start. Click on Solana, click on Radium. Then last 24 hours, change this over to 24 hours. And we want to be trading for the last 24 hour coins. And now we're going to go ahead and open up the next 30 coins and find what are some opportunities in the market. I'm sure we'll come across the particular coin that I'm currently in. And then when we do come across it, I'll go over the particular technical analysis that we need to. As I said, I usually hit to about this 40 to 50% range on the 24 hour right here. So we'll go down to 40. That's around 43 different coins that we're going to really quickly go over right now. So let's quickly have a look. Instantly no. So you can see how quickly I can go over all of these coins. Instantly no. We want to be seeing coins making high highs, consistently trending here. This is definitely a coin that I'd be interested in here. You can see we've got resistance in this area. We've then flipped it. We've broken to the upside. And now in this area would be a perfect look for a support. I'm currently already in a trade. I have all of my Solana already locked up. But these are the types of trades. See how instantly it pops out to me? So this would be one of the trades. And we can actually go over it later. Maybe just, and even though I'm not actually particularly in the trade, we can still go over it and make some analysis on it later. So we'll save that and move over to the next coin. Then we can see this coin, no. We would have liked to buy down here in this area. There would have been a bit of resistance, buy back here, get a bit of a bounce, but not really interested. Doge was actually one that we played yesterday here. Again, actually a decent coin. Resistance, resistance. Here we've got the breakup. Use it as support, then look for a continuation to the upside. So we'll keep this coin and we can just do some analysis later to see, okay, did it actually work or not? This one, no, we're not interested. No, we're not interested. No, we're not interested. Just quickly go through them all. Makes really easy. When I see these big moves to the upside, move over to the 5 minute. Potentially this one would be interesting. What I'd want to see is actually a break above this level and then use this level as the support. So I'd want to be buying here after we get the break up here. We could come back and analyze this. We'll leave that for later. That's what I like to do with a lot of these coins. Even here, we can see the support, the resistance flip worked really well. Initially resistance, breakdown, break up. Came back, used it as support, got a big break up. But right now we've got the breakdown, so we don't want to be looking at that particular coin. Even this one right here, actually cool. Look at this. Right through this zone right here would actually be a form of a resistance. We struggled to break through many, many times. Now we've got the breakout. Look to buy in this region. Look for a continuation to the upside. Again, another coin that I'll just save for later and come back to look at. Next, we see this coin. Definitely not something that I'm interested in. We continue on. We continue on. This coin might be interesting if we get some type of breakup above this level right here. And then we come back to use it as a support to resistance flip. We'll just save it and just come back and look at it in a later time. Moving on, just look at all these coins. Basically, just want to get as many opportunities as you can. Just basically filter any type of support to resistance opportunities that you can see. And see, we've got a few right here. We've got one. We've got two. We've got three. We've got four. We've got five. And you can see some of them are actually in the setup mode, whereas here, this one actually hasn't broken out, whereas this one's already broken out. Getting to the, so we're at different stages. One's already broken out. One's getting ready to break out. One's coming back to the support zone. Just good to really have a range. And actually, then you can go over the coins and make your assessment. Okay, this one has a little bit higher probability than that one. I'll take this trade. Or maybe actually you split your trade up, put 50% on both trades. Risk, actually decrease your risk. Potentially increase your probability. All these coins, not interested, not interested. Keep moving through. I don't like to see this big wick, although one, two, three pushes, making a bit of a wedge. Continue on. We continue through. Keep looking. With these type of ones, definitely want to scroll out because you don't know what's actually happening on the left. See, bang. You don't want to be trading this because I'm trading support to resistance flips. I want to be trading when it's breaking out to a new all-time high. We're very far away from the new all-time high. So clearly not a coin I want to be trading. Swift. Moving on to the next one. Moving same with this, where we really want to scroll out. Okay, yeah, this would be some type of zone right through this region right through here. Actually, definitely could be a potential support zone right through here. We've got one, two, three, four, and potentially come back for the support. So we'll save that and just look at it. At least it fits some type of support to resistance, whereas you look at this, it's got no support to resistance. Basically looks like a bit of a scam coin because everything is going straight up. So move over to the next coin, look at the 15-minute, move over to the 4-hour. What's happening here? Okay, so we're breaking out to new all-time highs. Basically, down here would have been an opportunity, but we never done it. Okay, just move on. There's no support to resistance flip here. Scroll out a little bit to see what's happening. Okay, yeah, definitely not a coin I want to be trading. Definitely not on this one. Now we have a look here. Solana. scroll out a little bit. Let's just go on the daily just to make sure. Yep, definitely not one I want to be trading. Maybe if we got a breakout above here, so we should get a breakout above this region here, could act. But again, I want to be trading when we've got the breakout above new all-time highs, because that just, again, just signifies to me higher probability in the market, because we're making new all-time highs rather than going back. Yeah, again, we're just coming back to a resistance point. Not very good. As much as making support to resistance flips here, when you scroll out, you can see we're coming to a resistance point. So do you really want to be buying at resistance rather than buying at support? Definitely not a coin here. Keep moving through, keep moving through. Don't find this one. Nope. Moving on to this one. Okay, interesting. Pank. Scroll out a little bit initially. Yeah, this could definitely fit. We'll save this one. This type of zone through here, resistance, resistance, resistance. Now getting a bit of a breakthrough. Definitely save it. It's some type of support to resistance flip. Then what we can do is actually come back and make an even better judgment. Even here, there we go. Beer is making a bit of a breakout right here. So right through this zone would be that support to resistance flip. If we came back, might be an area you want to be looking at. So we'll just save it and have a look in a minute when we come back and look at all the coins. Again, this one really acting as that trading range zone. So really want to be buying low and selling high, completely different strategy. But potentially, if you get a breakout above this zone right through here, that's where you want to be looking for the buy back through here for continuation up. So again, we'll just leave it here. You never know what type of price action you're going to get. Scroll out, see this one, go on to the daily. Yep, right now, not type of any support to resistance flip, because this was the last high, made a support off this zone. Yep, moving on. Keep going through. SC, yep, not a coin I'm interested in. This one, some type of support to resistance flip, but I don't like these single touch points. Sometimes don't make it as high a probability. This one, again, not really interesting. Cheeks coming over the daily. Not super interesting right now. And finally, we come over to my coin right here that I'm currently in a trade. We can actually scroll out and see right in this zone right here, we're actually making a bit of a resistance point here. We had resistance, resistance, and even through here, resistance, resistance. But finally, we got the breakout above this level. You can see right through here, we did get the breakout. And then what are we doing right now? We're having a single bar retest. That's why I got into my trade. Now looking for about that $50 million market cap. You see the next sort of resistance zone in the market, since we don't have anything to actually base it off, comes to around this $50 million market cap. That's where there's going to be some resistance in the market. You can also do a type of, this is a type of wedge. We can see we're making a type of a wedge to the sideways channel. Then what we can do is actually measure. So we grab, what we do is grab the triangle. What we do is grab the rectangle, go from this bottom all the way to the top, and then actually extend that to where we got the breakout. You see a move that's giving us around that 35 million. So maybe we'll get around 50% of that position out. But I reckon around that $50 million market cap is going to be that next sort of resistance zone in the market. You can see how we got the breakout coming back to retest. Looks like a really nice trade right here. So we've gotten into our trade. We know we have to risk down to here. So we definitely have a little bit of risk on the trade, but the reward is really, really solid. So we've entered the trade. Simple as that. Get into the trade. Don't get emotional about it. You find a trade that's got the support to resistance flip. Once you find the support to resistance flip, you just take the trade. You limit your risk. You don't put too much on the trade. So if you do end up losing, because trading is never a 100% game, if anybody ever tells you that they can win 100% of trades, I guarantee you that they're lying. You can never win 100% of trades. Even the probability trader that has something like a 40 or even a 30% chance of winning can have a really successful career, because he just sets up his trade that although he's only winning 30% of the time, he's winning 5, 6, and 10 times his risk, so that when he does win 33% of the time, he overall wins 10 times his risk. And although he does lose a lot, every time he does win, it makes up massively for those losses. So you can see the type of trades you need to be taking. Right now, we're actually starting. You can see in the last hour, came down, we got in this level right here. Now looking for that continuation to the upside. Really, really happy with this trade. Again, go through all of the trades that we've found today in the 5-minute chart. You see this one, if I had more capital, I'm actually really interested in this one. Let me move over to this one. A little bit more interesting. The reason I like this one before is because it's got multiple touches. 1, 2, 3 touches, then got the breakup. So I think this would have a higher probability, whereas this one actually only has 2 touches. 1, 2 touches, but 2 touches is still better than 1. Again, increased probability. Moving over to this one, this is more of a setup where we're waiting for to get to breakouts. This would be one that I keep for later on. Because as I said, I usually in the morning, I write down, I'm looking in the morning, then I'll come back later in the afternoon, come back in the later afternoon, and then I'll even come back right before I go to bed and go over everything that I need to look at for every single meme coin. And even for this one, if I find one that I need to save for later, we'll keep it later, keep it saved in the tab, and we'll come back later on. It's now much later in the day. Speed is still holding up. You need to be patient with some of these coins, especially this coin here, $20 million market cap. To get to a $50 million market cap, we need another $29 million invested for this coin to pump up. That's how everything works. For it to jump up a double, we'd need another $20 million of investment pumped into the coin. That's how it'd get to $40 million market cap. That's how it overall double in price. So need to understand, since this is a larger cap coin, it's going to take a lot longer compared to like a $500,000 market cap coin, where it only needs another $500,000 to actually double the market cap to $1 million. That's how everything actually works. So we're going to keep our position, going to hold it. It's still expecting high prices, especially with this increase in volume. Might just take a little bit longer. We're keen to watch it. If we need to get out of our position at a small loss, we'll get out of our position, but still can expect these high prices. I will put out this video, and if needed, in the next video, I will leave an update for this position. Don't forget to check out my meme coin mastery right here. It's still currently 50% off. I'm getting so many people messaging me asking it to keep it at this current price. You can watch my course directly through the website. Here is just the first introduction video, and you can watch them all right here. Once you actually purchase the course, watch it all directly through the website. I show you exactly from start to finish how I trade these meme coins, exactly how to get all your wallets set up, all the different bots that I use, everything from start to finish. And this 50% price is not going to last forever. Make sure that you smash the like, subscribe, leave a comment, tap the notification bell to stay up to date with all of the latest YouTube videos, and I'll see you in the next video.